Christmas.
Merry Christmas.
Thank you for coming to worship our Savior with us as we have the children present to you the marvels of God's love and the grace of our Savior Jesus being born in Bethlehem. So we'll be following illustrations of Emmanuel throughout the Old Testament. See some of the artwork that they did to demonstrate that, that's also printed in your bulletin. And please remember, this is a worship service, and so no flash photography. Be courteous to people around you if you want to take pictures and so on. No standing up and waving or anything like that. So, thank you. Let's begin in the name of the Father, and of the Son, and of the Holy Spirit. Amen. And we'll join in our first song, O Come, O Come, Emmanuel.
A picture paints a thousand words. Sometimes things can be difficult to explain verbally and can be better understood when depicted visually. Jesus also spoke using parables. These stories share spiritual truths of familiar things in our world, such as a mustard seed, a rebellious child, a wedding banquet, or a lost coin. In the same way, God gives illustrations that point to this central message of his holy word. He promised and sent us a Savior who is Christ the Lord. Let's gaze at wonder at some of these illustrations and renew our hearts in joy through our Savior Jesus.
In the first book of the Bible, Genesis chapter 3, we're told God created two perfect humans called Adam and Eve. Not long after they were created, they disobeyed God's command and brought the corruption of sin into the world. When God gave the first promise of a Savior, he spoke to Satan the tempter, who was in the form of a serpent. This offspring of Eve crushing Satan and all of his power underfoot. But the serpent is not only a picture of the problem of sin. Later in the Old Testament, there was a time when the Israelites were plagued by poisonous snakes and dying from their bites because of their rebellious sins. God commanded Moses to make a snake of bronze and hang it on a pole before the people. God promised to all who look at the bronze snake will be spared from death. Jesus recalls this event in John chapter 3. He shows how it points to the time when he himself will be hung on a cross to save all people.
Not. fall, Adam and Eve's family grew and began to fill the earth. Many years later, God appeared to one of Adam and Eve's descendants, Abraham, and God promised him that his descendants would number as all the stars in the sky and sand in the seashore. God also promised Abraham that the Savior would be born from his family. But later, God asked Abraham to do something unthinkable, something that seemed to have contradicted what he had said earlier. God asked Abraham to sacrifice his one and only son, Isaac.
Abraham took the wood for the burnt offering and placed it on his son Isaac. And he himself carried the fire and the knife. As the two of them went on together, Isaac spoke up. The fire and the wood are here, but where is the lamb for the burnt offering? Abraham answered, God himself will provide the lamb for the burnt offering, my son.
Isaac did not die that day. As Abraham was about to sacrifice his son, God stopped him and provided a ram as a substitute for him. Each one of us cannot make a sufficient sacrifice for our every sin. Staring eternal death in the face, we see in 1 Peter that God himself provided his own son to be our substitute. Jesus' perfect love provides the perfection we are unable to achieve on our own. Jesus' death on the cross at Calvary paid for our every sin. As God the Father rightfully raises his hand to kill each of us for our sins, he stops himself and provides his son as a substitute for our every sin. Listen as the Apostle Peter explains.
Jesus committed no sin, and no deceit was found in his mouth. When they hurled their insults at him, he did not retaliate. When he suffered, he made no threats. Instead, he entrusted himself to him who judges justly. He himself bore our sins in
The grandson of Abraham was Jacob, whom God gave the name Israel. His descendants became the nation of Israel, and they were enslaved in Egypt for hundreds of years. God used the nation's exodus from Egypt as another illustration that points to the coming of our Savior, the Lamb of God. On the night before the Israelites were freed from slavery, God gave the following instructions to Moses.
Protected the Israelites from the righteous wrath of God. Centuries later, John the Baptist, who was Jesus' cousin, pointed to Jesus as the perfect sacrifice, whose blood would cleanse the whole world from their sins, recalling the final plague in Egypt and the blood of the Lamb by which God's people were saved from death. John points to Jesus with these words.
After delivering his people from slavery in Egypt, God led the nation of Israel to the land of Canaan, which had been promised to Abraham. Here Israel would become a great nation. It will be ruled one day by King David. But prophet Isaiah tells us that King David's father, Jesse, would be the stump from which the branch of the promised Savior would come forth.
Counsel and of might, the spirit of the knowledge and peace.
The prophet Micah points to the Messiah who would be born in Bethlehem, the town of King David.
But you, Bethlehem Ephrathah, though you are small among the clans of Judah, out of you will come for me one who will be ruler over Israel, whose origins are from of old, from ancient times.
Finally, the time came for the Savior to come to earth, for the Messiah to be made man, for the promised and prophesied one to be born and placed in the manger. Isaiah clearly shows us that this is no ordinary baby. He came from the majesty of heaven to become like us, human, born of a virgin. He is God with us, Emmanuel.
For
invite our graduates of Jordan, Woodlawn, and Lamb of God Lutheran Schools, and I can see you from here, to come up. You can either stand on that side or that side. You can bring your bulletins if you forgot the words. But to join us in singing the first stanza of Silent Night, after the first stanza, then you can head back to your seats and join the rest of the congregation for stanzas 2 and 3.
In Luke chapter 2, angels proclaim the arrival of the long-awaited Savior of the world to shepherds watching their sheep just outside of Bethlehem. The message and the messengers were a spectacular sight and sound, but the Messiah would be found, seemingly helpless and in a lonely place.
Each to his own town.
the birth of the Savior would be meaningless had he not completed the work he came into this world to accomplish. Jesus himself pointed to his own death and resurrection when he talked with Nicodemus about the sign of Jonah.
When he rose from the dead, he crushed the power of Satan underfoot and proclaimed victory over death, not just for himself, but for all who place their trust in him. Paul writes to the believers in Corinth to assure them that through the resurrection of Christ Jesus, they too will live eternally with him in heaven.
Christ has indeed been raised from the dead, the first fruits of those.
Beginning to end and everywhere in between, God illustrates pictures for us that point to his son Jesus, the King of Kings, who came down from heaven and was born in a lowly manger. He became one of us. He lived perfectly in our place. He suffered the consequences of our sins. He completed the work of our salvation and his resurrection. Because of all of this, we are guaranteed victory over sin and death, and promised eternal joy in heaven, where we will join to sing the praises of the King of Kings forever.
Thank you.
Let's all rise for prayer. Dear Father in heaven, we thank you for the opportunity you have given us this evening to join with family and friends to hear the good news that you have sent your Son into the world to be our Savior. We see from the illustrations how you guided us to your love shown in Bethlehem throughout our lives. Keep us close to you and to this good news. In Christ's name we pray. Amen. So before we walk out, a few directions here. After the service, head down to the school wings to find your children. You cannot leave them here. They will be in the rooms getting their coats. In the rooms, you will have the Christmas bags to be distributed to, and that you may leave from after you pick up your kids. May the love of God the Father, Son, and Holy Spirit bless and keep us tonight and forever.